This video is step-by-step instructions for creating an assignment in repl.it that uses unit testing to do the grading. So this is a great functionality, so let me step through this. Go to repl.it and then log in. I'm already logged in through Google. And then make sure you switch to the teacher profile. Have the teacher options here. You need to choose a course. In another video, I created this classroom. Check that out. Click on create an assignment. And here we're gonna say an average of a list of numbers, okay? And now for this assignment, we're gonna have the students, have the students complete a function. And so sometimes it's helpful to provide the function for them so that they have it there and they can't misspell it. So that's one thing that they don't have to worry about. And so here the assignment I'm saying is to complete this function, to give it parameters, and I'm stating the assumptions here that all the values in the list are going to be either an int or a float. And then here we're formatting it to be accurate. And I provided examples for the students so that this function is going to return approximately 9.35. Approximately, because we will only evaluate it to two decimal places just to make sure as it's running on, if it's running on a different system and the precision was just a little bit different or whatever the case may be, that we ignore that. Or if they use a different method of calculation than what the unit test uses, that will account for that. You probably want to set the due date so that it stops, so that it marks students' late submissions as that. And so now so this is close to how the students would see it. It's almost the same. They start with this, they can run it in this little Linux shell here, and then these are the instructions, but we can edit it in this view since we're in teacher mode and not student preview. So here now we click on automatic unit tests, and then we go to create a new test. And so let's create two, and let's name this first one first example to identify that it's the first example from the description that was given. And then here, this is what happens. The students see this message when if they fail the unit test. And so this, you can give them a hint, or if there's common things that students miss, then you could put that right in here. Now here's a place for the code to get executed. And so let's put that here. This is actually wrong, but I'll use it as a teaching opportunity to show you what happens when things go wrong, because we're going to assert that it must be exactly 9.35, and in a minute we'll see that that's not accurate, that's not going to work. And there we go. We've created a unit test by asserting that they are equal by calling the student's average. Notice we did not define average anywhere in here. This is the student, we're calling the student's method for average, and then checking that against 9.35. Now, let's create a more in-depth one, which is one of the things I love about repl.it. And let's label this one random, because what we're going to be able to do here is we're going to be able to execute code just like here, but that we are able to generate values that are random. So here I'll type real fast to respect your time. Oh, and we just got a second one. Yes, delete this case. I'm sorry. Right there. Okay. So we're going to create a list of between 2 and 9 random numbers between 0 and close to 100. And then we're going to assert that they are within 2 decimal places of precision. And we're going to do this replicates number of time. And so notice this is all in a for loop here. And so we're actually going to go through 3 times to test it, to generating random numbers to really make sure that they're getting it right. 1 is probably sufficient, but while we're here, let's just put it in a loop anyway. And so the list is a variable length because we're just executing code and we can choose that. So we know that students didn't hard code something like the length of the list. And then here we're just generating random numbers. And then here we actually do the calculation. And now we assert that it's almost equal, calling the student's average, comparing against ours up to 2 decimal places of precision. Now we're really all done and we can publish, but it's good form to test it by going into student mode here. And let me just copy and paste some code into here. And so here is the solution for average. We're just taking the sum divided by length as was shown in the test case. And then notice we can also have these print statements here. For unit testing, they won't execute. And sometimes I'll leave these in for students to make sure things are running, and we can execute it here and see what it's going to produce as a result. So now when we click submit, notice, oh no, the test failed. And so this is what it would look like for a student. So you can click on this and notice here's that statement that was a comment. Hey, it should have returned 9.3. And so here it says, hey, the assertion error 9.31 does not equal 9.35. And so that was our fault as the instructor. And so we need to change this to almost equals. And then let's specify it at 2 decimal places of precision. Okay, and then it'll save it. And then we can submit it again and say, okay, good, that one passed, but this one failed. And so we can look into it. And it says random is not defined. Okay, well, that would be the same thing a student would get in their code if they did not import random. And here there's only, not all libraries are accessible, but random is, thankfully. So if we import random here, and notice that was a bug in the code when it tried to do the unit testing. So now if we click submit again, oh yep, it passed all the tests. And if I was a student, I'd click submit and be happy that I passed. And so now we know that it's working. And so, and it, notice it didn't save the code here because we're in student mode. So if we go back to edit and go back here, it just has the template here. And I'm not setting the due date because this isn't for a real course, but do that and then publish it. And then publish it, and there you go. You've created a unit tested, auto-graded assignment in repl.it. Check out my other videos in this series.